Evening, people.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Evening. Par de minutos.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. Okay. Muy bien, habla asistente, ¿ya? Aleida Verónica Manzor.
Present, teacher.
Present, teacher.
Ana Gloria Shuniko.
Present.
Ya tomaste café.
Okay, welcome. Andrea Alejandra Naya.
Present, teacher.
Okay, welcome. Claudia Michelle Hernandez.
Present, teacher.
Okay, welcome. Daniel Armando Espinosa.
Present.
Welcome. Diana Lizeth Jimenez. Fernando Balmore Díaz. Jaime José Oya. Jennifer Michelle López. José Alirio Pérez. José Emilio Ramos. José Gerardo de León. Juan de Jesús Mejía. Miriam Estela Argueta.
Present, teacher.
Sofía del Carmen León. Tania Janet Aguilar.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Y a ver lo último. Vamos. Tenemos algunos nada más. Okay, number one is there a supermarket? Is there a supermarket? Yes, there is another reason, people. Oh, there are. ¿Cuál es la respuesta?
Yes, there is.
Yes, there is. Are there three cars?
No, there aren't.
No, there aren't.
Is there a swimming pool?
No, there isn't.
Is there a dog? Here.
Yes, it is. It
yeah.
is.
Yes,
there
is, okay. Are there two parks?
Yes. Yes, they are.
Yes, there are.
Yes, there are. There are. Are there two shops? Shops.
Yes, there
are. No, there are.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Is there a school bus?
Yes.
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 Is there a hotel?
Yes.
Hotel?
Yes.
No.
No, no.
No,
no there is.
Are there two supermarkets?
Yes. Yes, they are.
Yes, they are.
No, there aren't.
Yes or no? I'm here. School bus is. Is there a zoo?
No, there isn't.
Va a salir dos, ah, no va a salir. Okay, esto, ¿cómo lo ordenamos?
There is a supermarket.
Is there a supermarket? Number two is a question.
Is there a bakery? Yes, there is. Is there a bank?
No.
No, there isn't.
No, there isn't.
There aren't two cinemas.
Cinema.
There aren't two hospitals. Are there three shops? Yes, there are. There isn't a post office.
Okay. So there is a bike in front of the hospital. There is a bank between a shop and a school. Between a bank and a school. There is a bank between a shop and a school. La tienda y la escuela. There is a blue car in front of the supermarket. There is a dog next to the supermarket. There is a restaurant next to the bakery. In front of, frente, between, en medio, next to, and up. There is a cinema between a shop and a park. Cinema between entre la tienda y el parque. There is a school.
Next to
park. There is a bakery. In front of. There is a supermarket. In front of. Hospital. There is a post office. next to
the shop.
There is a supermarket, a hospital, and a farm. Between the hospital and the farm. Bueno, voy a como mostrar todo esto. Ok, aquí estamos bien. Bien. Okay, perfect. Is there a supermarket? Yes, there is. Are there three cars? No, there aren't. Is there a swimming pool? No, there isn't. Is there a dog? Yes, there is. Are there two parks? Yes, there are. Are there two shops? Yes, there are. Is there a school bus? Yes, there is. Is there a hotel? No, there isn't. Are there two supermarkets? No, there aren't. Is there a zoo? No, there isn't. Okay. There is a supermarket. Is there a bakery? Yes, there is. Is there a bank? No, there isn't. There aren't two cinemas. There are two hospitals. Are there two restaurants? No, there aren't. Are there three shops? Yes, there are. There isn't a post office. Yes, okay. Ubicar lugares. Between, entre, next, no. Between up, no, front off, between, entre, and medio, next to, okay, un quick review de lo que vimos ayer. Today we're going to start lesson three. At the end of the class, you will be able to describe how my and others' working places and areas look like. In places and areas look like. Describe how my or and others working places and areas look like. Okay, look like es como se ven. So we're going to describe our working place, not the location, but the characteristics of our working place. Okay. Look at these descriptions and guess, adivine, guess where they work. Tratemos de adivinar o de imaginar where they work. First, they say, there is a beautiful lobby. There is, this is Mr. Paz. Okay, let me write here. This is Mr. Paz. There is a beautiful lobby. There are comfortable rooms. There are comfortable rooms. There is a huge. Huge is big, very big parking lot. Parking lot. And there are three high-tech elevators. High-tech. High-tech is high technology. Modern means modern elevators. Okay, Mr. Paz works in that place. At Mr. Paz's workplace, there is a beautiful lobby. There are comfortable rooms. There is a huge, big parking lot. There are three elevators, high technology elevator, of modern elevators. Where do you think Mr. Paz works? Where do you think Mr. Paz works?
Mr. Paz works at the hotel.
At
a hotel.
Ah, could be, yes. That is a good guess. Probably a hotel. Any other idea? Beautiful lobby, comfortable rooms, big parking lot, high tech elevators, probably is a hotel. Nice place. Let's see, Mrs. Aguilar. Oh, the name is here. Mrs. Aguilar. Let's take a look at her workplace. There is a narrow reception area. Narrow reception area. Narrow is, how can I say that? Narrow. Narrow is like, it's narrow reception area. There are two dirty dining rooms. Dirty dining rooms. Do you know what is dirty? What is the meaning of dirty? Is the opposite of clean. Yes. Dirty is the opposite of clean. Mm-hmm. Two dirty dining rooms. There is an ugly photocopy center. Ugly photocopy center. Okay. Ugly is the opposite of pretty or the opposite of beautiful. Ugly. And there are small offices. Small offices. Okay. Where does she work? Where do you think she works? Any idea? Use your imagination. A narrow reception area or two dirty dining rooms, an ugly photocopy center, small offices. What I said.
Could be a recycle pub.
Hay mucho ruido ahí y no se te comprende. Hace ruido.
Sorry. A recycle pub. Would be.
Yeah, I don't understand what you say. There is a noise in the background. I just hear park. Okay.
Call center.
Now teacher.
It's better. Siempre hay un ruido ahí.
The workplace. It's called center.
Maybe. O sea, aquí estamos adivinando. No hay una respuesta correcta. ¿Qué lugares pueden ser?
A recycle fabric.
Ah, recycling. Factory.
Factory.
Okay. I don't know, it's a factory. Recycling plant. Maybe more than a factory, recycling
cafeteria.
Cafeteria, maybe
like university.
Okay. What about a car shop? What is a car shop? Car garage. Taller. Okay, different option. No. What about your workplace, people? Your workplace is more like Mr. Paz or like Mrs. Aguilar? Difficult question. I don't know. Okay. Like Mr. Fast.
Mr. Fast.
Yeah, Haynes has beautiful. Haynes has nice buildings, nice coffee, nice coffee. I have been there. The facilities, las instalaciones, the facilities are okay. So we have three questions here. How does Mr. Paz describe his workplace? What does Mrs. Aguilar think about her workplace? On which of the two places do you want to work? What adjectives does Mr. Paz use to describe his workplace? These are the adjectives Mr. Paz uses to describe his workplace. Said that dice que his workplace is beautiful, comfortable, huge, and high tech. high technology. Nice. And Mrs. Aguilar says that her workplace is narrow, dirty, ugly, and small. If you see, they use an adjective and the place. Adjectives plus place or noun. A beautiful lobby. A comfortable rooms. A huge parking lot. High-tech elevators. Narrow reception area. Dirty dining rooms. Ugly photocopy center. Small offices. Okay. Now, we have here some positive adjectives and negative adjectives. Positive adjectives. Comfortable. You. Nice. Number one, illuminated. Positive adjectives. Good. Good qualities. Good characteristics. Now, negative adjectives. Narrow reception area. All offices. Disgusting kitchen area. Smelly living room. Okay, we have positive adjectives and negative adjectives. And always observe. After the adjective, después del adjective, tenemos un noun. Comfortable rooms. Huge parking lot. Nice places to rest. Illuminated training room. Narrow reception area. Small offices. Disgusting kitchen area. Smelly living room. Okay. And of course, we have these two samples. There is. Okay. Now, you have to write sentences here. There is, there are, and the adjective and the nouns. For example, number one, tell me. Let me usar. There is or there are?
There is.
Yes, it's singular. Yeah? There is a small gym. Continue with 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, please. Okay, write in the chat, please, sentence number two. Number two in the chat, please. Two. No, number two is this, the training room. Ah, no. I'm sorry, there are two number two. Oh my God. The training rooms, okay? One, two, esta debe ser two. Oh, mira, ya le cambié el número. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But two is new training room. Number two. Is okay, there are new training rooms. Number three is clean cafeterias. And there are clean cafeterias. Four. Now four, meeting room. Number four, waiting for number four, smartphone, no smartphone. Is number five, unpleasant bathrooms, unpleasant bathrooms. Plural, it's plural. Five. I'm on number five. Five.
Teacher,
yes,
I have a doubt.
Huh?
How is the pronunciation of that word on pleasant bathroom?
Unpleasant, unpleasant.
And what's the meaning?
The meaning is desagradable.
Ah, okay. Thank you, teacher.
Remember that you have the dictionary. I gave you to help you. Let's take a look. Unpleasant. El opuesto es en el on, solo es pleasant. Okay, so number five, there are I'm plural. Unpleasant. Plural no tiene que llevar a ni an. And finally, number six. And there is a tiny cubicle. Okay. So we have these adjectives. Green. Unpleasant, new, smart, tiny. Okay, ahora quiero que usando estos adjetivos. Esto que está aquí. Todo esto. Bueno, sí. Oh, bueno. Positivos y otros son negativos. ¿Qué más? Lo que quiero que hagan es que escriban 5 sentences, 5 oraciones acerca de su workplace, ¿no? Describiendo diferentes áreas de su workplace. Hablamos del inglés corporativo. There are a lot of there are many other air conditioners. There is no parking. There nice restroom. There is a modern
teacher.
Yes.
Disculpe, ¿será que solo puedo estar escuchando? Me duele mucho la cabeza, demasiado. Me está molestando el reflejo de la pantalla.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Estas son algunas characteristics of inglés corporativo, en las oficinas y la inicial. ¿Ya? Te lo pongo como ejemplo. Quiero que algo así hagan sobre su empresa, sobre su. ¿Okay? Okay. Entonces, escriban 5 sentences about your workplace, different areas at your workplace using the adjectives, okay? Vamos. Ok, voy a colocarlos en grupos y quiero que compartan ahí sus... Okay. Ok, join the breakout rooms and talk about the sentences, ok, about your workplace. Okay, I'd like to hear some of your sentences. Let's start with, okay, any volunteer? Tell me about your workplace.
Me.
Okay, Aleida.
For example, in my workplace, there are four big production departments.
Hmm?
There are two beautiful cars. There is a great area to room. There is a big parking lot.
Okay.
And there is a great cafeteria.
Okay. Thank you. Aleida.
Okay.
Pass la pelota. Pass the ball to another participant.
Ah, Jose Ilirio. El Alirio.
Alirio, okay. A ver, Alirio, ¿tienes algo?
Ahorita estoy desconectado, teacher. No sé lo que han estado haciendo.
Okay. Okay.
Estoy escuchando aquí.
Ah, okay, okay.
Sí.
Otro, Aleida, otra persona.
Daniel Armando Espinosa.
Okay.
Okay. My sentence is there is a huge company. Okay. There are beautiful gardens. There are clean living rooms. There are comfortable vehicles, and there are smart machines.
Okay. How's the ball, Daniel?
Andrea?
To Andrea.
Lea. Answer. Another one, Daniel.
Juan.
Juan is not in class today.
He's not in class. Okay. Miriam.
Miriam is not either.
Okay. Jose Emilio.
Emilio.
Okay, let me check.
Yeah, we have a lot of problems this day.
Claudia.
Okay. In my workplace, there are a lot of trees. There are two clean cafeterias. And there is a medical emergency. I don't know how to say, clinicas.
Clinic.
Ah, okay, clinic. There are a lot of parking and there are a lot of office.
Okay, good, Claudia, but
okay.
Can you use some adjectives to describe those things?
Okay, like how?
I don't know, the trees, how could you describe the trees?
The trees are very big.
Okay, so there are a lot of big trees.
Okay, there are a lot of big trees.
What about the clinic?
The clinic, there is a clinic, but it's a small clinic.
Okay.
But it's complete. They have a I don't know how to say maternity space.
Ah, okay.
And the parking, there, it's too much parking. I don't know how to describe it, but.
Okay, I can say huge, big.
Okay. They enormous. Have a bus, bus parking.
Ah, okay. Okay.
And the office, it's a huge office.
Okay.
It's the Penta department, but okay. They have a big space.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Pass the ball, Claudia.
Jaime Oya.
Okay, Jaime.
Hi, good night, teacher.
So,
in my world, there is an artificial lake, and there are industrial washing machines. There are three industrial washing machines, and there are two cafeterias, and there are a lot of parking.
Okay. How could you describe the cafeterias with an adjective?
In the cafeteria is big and have a chair, table, and a lot of people.
Okay. Very good. We still have Gerardo only. Gerardo?
Hello?
Can you tell us some sentences?
Okay. There are clean parts. They are a small bedroom. There is a nude meeting room. They are a small office. There is a nice place to work.
Okay. Okay. Very good. Very good. Now, let's I want to share this chart with you just to know the difference or between adjectives and nouns. Okay. You have a list of words here. Yeah. 2, 4, 6, 7, 21 words. You have to classify them in adjectives and nouns. Okay? For example, the first one, teacher. Teacher is an adjective or a noun, people?
Noun.
It's a noun, yeah? Okay, so teacher. That way, okay? Quiet. Quiet is an adjective or a noun?
Adjective.
Quiet is an adjective, right? Okay? So that's what I want you to do, okay? Classify these words in adjectives and nouns. Adjectives and nouns. I'll send you to working groups to do this, okay? A couple of groups. You can help each other, okay? Join the groups, please, and classify these words in adjectives and nouns. Okay, vamos. Let's make a list of the okay, give me all the adjectives. Denme todos los adjetivos que encontraron. Dígame. Una columna.
Small.
Sharp.
Happy.
Okay, happy.
Lucky. Sharp.
Sharp. Lucky.
Okay. Found.
Happy, sharp, lucky. Una columna.
Happy.
Pink,
fun,
fun,
pink,
pink,
pink, white,
pink for now.
White, white,
white,
hot. A small,
small, small,
many,
right? Many.
Beach viene siendo adjetivo.
All the rest are now.
What that means, bridge.
Bright.
Bright. Sorry? Okay. Thank you.
Okay, entonces los nouns son teacher,
dog,
dog,
pencil,
ball,
ball,
okay,
cake, bolt,
bolt,
home, Sue. Baby, doctor, mom,
Doctor, Gustavo.
Many. Is a noun or is a
many. Yeah, un adjective. Okay, good. Now I want to share a link with you. This is let's use this one. Okay, there you have the link in WhatsApp. I'll send it to Zoom. Okay, and the exercises. This is a vocabulary of adding. Hay una lista de adjetivos aquí y lo dibujo. Sí. Here is to drag and drop. Darlo al lugar correcto. Entonces, adjetivos. Okay. Ahí se los dejo. Please.
English teacher.
Ok, people, mientras siguen ahí, voy a tomar la última asistencia. Aleida Verónico Mansur. Ana Gloria Shuriko.
Present, present, present.
Ok, Andrea Alejandra Anaya. Claudia Michelle Hernández.
Present.
Daniel Armando Espinosa.
Present.
Diana Lizeth Jiménez. Fernando Balmore Díaz. Jaime José Olla.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Jennifer Michelle López. José Lirio Pérez.
Present, teacher.
Emilio Ramos. Okay. José Gerardo de León.
Present.
Juan de Jesús Mejía. Miriam Estela Argueta. Sofía del Carmen León. Vitania Janet Aguilar.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Bien. Mañana vamos a revisar ese ejercicio y lo terminan tranquilamente. Recuerden también que estamos ya por terminar el módulo. Si es que terminan las tareas de la unidad 4, please, y el examen final. Good night. See you tomorrow.
Good night.
Bye. Bye.